Hello, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Exotic Astrology. We are back with the transit video for Venus today, and this is drikpanchang.com, and this is 8:25 a.m. German time, Munich, 10th of April 2021. And if you check here, Venus has entered the sign of Aries, 0 degrees 16 minutes. All right. So I had spoken about this in my last video, that Venus will be entering Aries by the 10th, and before that it was in Pisces, where it was trying to let go of things which it tried to achieve, which it could not. And now when Venus enters Aries, this is a wonderful time to begin a new cycle. So if you check properly here, Venus is already in Aries during this time that I'm making this video, so you must have already started feeling the effects. So Pisces and Aries, this is a very critical energy, and currently when I'm making this video, because Venus is in 0 degrees of a fire sign, and we know that the last degree of a water sign and the first degree of a fire sign is known as Gandanta. Gandanta means something is ending and a new cycle is beginning. So all of you watching this video, you can check which houses Venus rules in your chart. So you know Venus rules two houses, Taurus, and it rules Libra. So whichever house these two signs are falling in, depending on your bhav chart, those are the houses which Venus rules, and those houses will undergo a flavor of as if something new is going to start here. But every year Venus transits into Aries, and every year if we say, oh, something new is going to start, well then it doesn't make sense to make the same video every year, because every year Venus will transit to Aries. What is that which is different every year, and specifically what is that which is different this year? That is something which we really need to understand. Otherwise we will just keep saying, oh, new beginnings are going to come, but how is it different from last year? So I don't know what was the planetary position last year, where were the planets, but if you check this year, you check it very clearly. If you see which are the planets that are placed in the sign of Venus, so let me repeat, which are the planets that are placed in the signs of Venus, which are the planets? So Taurus and Libra, if you check here, Libra is empty, which is pretty obvious. And there will be no planets transiting in Libra for the entire 25 days when Venus will be in Aries, so it doesn't make sense to see Libra. But if you see Taurus, there are a lot of interesting energies which are happening, which are affecting us in Taurus. If you see there, Rahu and Mars is placed. Rahu and Mars, they are place, but they are quite far. If you see, Rahu is in 19 degrees, it is retrograde, so it will be going to Aries later on. And Mars is forward, okay, so Mars is in 27 degrees, so almost 8 degree difference, and then Mars is going ahead, it will enter Gemini after some days. So therefore, these two planets will try to impart their effects to Venus. Okay, why? Because these two planets, they see, whenever a planet transits the sign of Venus, what happens is that planet feels that I need to behave like Venus. Not that I have to become Venus, but I have to behave the way Venus behaves, okay, because that's the house of Venus. Because the only resources that you have in Taurus is the resources of Venus. So it's like saying you make the best use of a bad bargain. So Now Rahu and Mars, it's like saying they have entered a home and then they see all Venusian things there. So then they are trying to impart those energies, their own energies, the Rahu energy and Mars energy, to the house through the Venusian resources. And Venus becomes the dispositor. And if you check, Mars and Venus currently are undergoing Parivartan Yoga, which means Mars is in the sign of Venus and Venus is in the sign of Mars. Okay. So this is a very interesting thing. So therefore, we see that Mars and Rahu are conjunct in the sign of Venus, which means the placement of Venus will decide how will Mars and Rahu function. So now Venus is in the sign of Aries, which is beginning. So if you see here, Ashwini Nakshatra is the first Nakshatra. Okay. So that means, see, Ashwini Nakshatra has this tendency, because Ashwini is the place, the Nakshatra where the soul comes into the existence, into the material existence. So therefore, not Venus, but the houses which Mars rules in your chart. Okay, why do I say Mars? Because Venus is the dispositor of Mars. So the houses which Mars rules in your chart might undergo a feeling as if something new is happening, in the sense that some new creation is happening, some new beginning is happening. And Ashwini Nakshatra is related to the horse, which means, now the horse is a very fast moving animal, but what people forget is that the horse is not only fast moving, the horse is also considered to be a very beautiful animal, somebody who is very attractive. So therefore, it could happen the energy that the houses which Mars and Venus, they are ruling in your chart, they undergo a sense of need for beautification or, you know, external decoration. This can happen. And it could happen that you are seeking validation also from the external world, or you are trying to do things in a way because of which it feels that it is more appealing than what it is actually. And there could be a lot of anger issues and difficulty to control one's tongue especially. So therefore, it is very important that we really take care regarding what do we speak, okay? Especially because Mars and Rahu are conjunct. And of course now, Mars and Rahu, they are conjunct, but they are separating. Mars is going ahead and Rahu is retrograde. But still the energy is there. Till the time Mars is in Taurus, this energy will be there. Okay. And then later on, Venus will enter Bharani Nakshatra. So what is the difference between Ashwini and Bharani? Ashwini is the Nakshatra which gives you a need to prove something to others. But what does Bharani do? Bharani gives you this feeling that, well, you have to pay the price. So therefore, Bharani has everything to do with purification and paying something to somebody. So nothing comes for free in this world. You always have to pay something to somebody. Okay. So therefore, the houses which Venus rules in the chart, you might feel that when Venus enters Bharani after like 9 to 10 days, so by 20th of April almost, 21st of April, you might feel as if you have to pay a heavy price, a very heavy price, to get those areas moving in your life. Okay. And then after 20 days, Mars will enter Kritika Nakshatra. Now, what is Kritika Nakshatra? Kritika Nakshatra is a very interesting nakshatra. It tells you that if you want something, which is Ashwini, you have to pay the price, which you pay in Bharani Nakshatra. But Kritika tells you, paying a price doesn't just mean you do what you are being told to, but you also have to make yourself eligible. You have to make yourself, you have to be capable of handling the power and responsibility that comes with it. Okay, so imagine you want to, like in India, people are always preparing for government exams. In other countries also, but in India, there is this big craze of UPSC and IAS exams. So imagine a candidate is there, he says he wants to prepare for becoming an IAS officer. So that is like Ashwini Nakshatra. And then he does all the preparation. He goes through UPSC exams, he cracks it in 1, 2, 3, 4 attempts. That is like Bharani Nakshatra. You are paying the price. But once he gets through it, the exam, the main prelims, mains, and the interview, and then finally he becomes an IAS officer. Then he or she has to undergo training, right? Because that training will teach them how should you maintain your position. Okay? So just wishing something and getting something is not enough. You have to have that much capacity by which you can maintain what you got there, what you wanted basically. So therefore, when Venus enters Kritika Nakshatra, you will get this feeling that yes, I wanted something, I paid the price, but now I have to really make myself capable in order to handle that which I got, that which I wanted. And on the other hand, we see that Sun, Moon, today, as of today, they are they are in the sign of Pisces, and by the next 2 days, there will also be the new moon in Pisces. Now, this is a very interesting energy because we know Mercury is in debility, Mercury is in Pisces, and we see that the new moon is happening in the sign of Pisces. That means the luminaries, Sun and Moon, are in the sign of Pisces, where Venus was till yesterday. And Venus was also giving Nij Bhanga to Mercury. But now this Mercury is not having support from Venus. So I made this video about on debilitation of Mercury in Pisces. And in that video I said that Mercury debilitated means we may feel that the decisions which we have made, we may have this inner self-doubt that maybe those decisions will not give us the maximum returns. But when Venus is with Mercury, what happens? Venus tells Mercury, even if you do not see the results, but it is important that you take that as an experience. Not learning necessarily. You may learn or you may not learn, but Venus also tells Mercury that you must learn how to enjoy and absorb yourself during the process. And not just think, oh, this result has come, I did everything perfectly. The problem with Mercury in Pisces is Mercury has to give up his quest for perfection. So now Venus was giving Nij Bhanga, but now Venus has left. And now that too. This Sun and Moon, they are conjunct in Pisces for the next 2 days. So Sun, Mercury and Moon in Pisces and Venus in Aries. So this is a very dual energy. This is a type of energy where externally we are not yet seeing the results, but internally we are still wanting to believe that maybe I will be seeing the results one day. There is some area in your life which you know is going to fructify very soon externally. But you are thinking, how did it go? Was it all worth it? All the fights, all the quarrels, all the bickerings, all the misunderstandings, all the conflicts, especially related to the houses which Mars rules in your chart. Why Mars? Because Mars Rahu are conjunct. Okay, they are still conjunct though. So from last 1 to 2 months, you might have seen there has been a lot of bickering related to the houses which Mars rules in your chart. And then we have this Sun Moon in Pisces. So this energy is like telling you, it's forcing you to question yourself. What you did, was it right? Or could could you think of any other alternative? And then we have Venus in Aries. Now Venus in Aries is trying to tell you that look, whatever you wanted, maybe you achieved or maybe you did not achieve. But it is now important that you move ahead in life, because you cannot sit and keep crying over the things that you lost or the things that you could not achieve, the things where you failed. So now the lesson for this Venus in Aries is, it's very simple, that I wanted something really bad and maybe I got it or maybe I did not get it, depending on my dashas, which is related to Mars, of course. And now I am forced to introspect because of this Sun, Moon, Mercury in the sign of Pisces. At the same time, I have to move ahead, which is the Venus in Aries. So therefore, this energy is very harmonious for us to look over and ponder the things that we lost, that we gained in the past 3 to 4 months, and keeping those lessons in our heart, it is time that we move on, move ahead in life. Okay, because there are some things which we cannot get. That is how the material world has been designed, that whatever you have or whoever you are, you will always have some disappointments. Okay, you can never say, not even Indra can say that my wishes have been fulfilled always. But whatever has been fulfilled, depending on our efforts and our karma, our destiny, bhagya, we accept it and we move ahead and we welcome this new beginning which is coming in the areas of the houses ruled by Mars and Venus. Okay, that will be all from my side. If you are new to the channel, then please subscribe to it down below. And if you want a consultation from me regarding this transit or body or your relationships, career, finances, married life or spirituality, you can always go to my website. You will find the link to my website down in the description section. Okay, God is there with you all the time. Just look to him and he will help you to move ahead with this Venus in Aries. All right, thank you very much. Jai Shri Ram.